You see that right there? That is Edu cooking. No, he is not baking a cake, he is not barbecuing, he is not frying eggs. He is cooking transfers. That is exactly what he's doing. And he's cooking it with Brazilian sauce and a bit of Argentine sauce on the side as well. Wow. Like, who knew this would be Arsenal? Who knew this would be Arsenal we are going to be talking about this early in the transfer window? Not me. Definitely not me. On this one, welcome to Everything Arsenal by the way. On this one, we'll be talking about Jesus, Rafinha, obviously our Brazilians, and Lisandro Martinez, the Argentine. It's always good to have a bit of Brazilian food and a bit of Argentine sauce on the side. So according to Jules, the French journalist, he has had this to say about Jesus: only paperwork and medical pending for Gabriel Jesus deal. So I'm expecting the medical, according to reports, they're expecting the medical to be done around Monday or Tuesday, which is very early, which is still in June. Hopefully, we get the deal completely done in June, but it's looking very likely that this will be an Arsenal player by the end of June. Medical is set. They still not told us the day, but probably I'm expecting it on Monday or Tuesday. The only thing remaining, paperwork and the medical itself. And Gabriel Jesus will be an Arsenal player. I did a video talking about where Gabriel Jesus will fit at Arsenal, in case you haven't checked it out. I'll link it up in the YouTube card right now, and the link will also be in the description. Really, really quality player. Next up is Rafinha. According to reports, one of the reports said Arsenal are getting ready to submit new improved bids for both Rafinha and Lisandro Martinez next week. And another report actually said that Rafinha is meeting up with Arsenal by Tuesday alongside Deco and his agents. They are planning a meeting with Edu in the next 48 hours. That is what it said. I cannot wait, man. I cannot wait for this deal to go through. As of now, we are the only team that is going for him. Chelsea are looking at Sterling. Tottenham are looking at Richarlison. Barcelona are not in the race at the moment. This could be a deal. There's another report I've read as well that says that it's not even going to be 60 or 70 million euros. It's going to be as little as 50 million pounds, around that, Leeds are ready to accept a 50 million pound deal because they don't want to stand in the way of Rafinha going to a European club. They didn't really specify Champions League or Europa League. They said Rafinha would be happy to play in any European competition. And since Arsenal is the only team there, you'd rather play in the Europa League with Arsenal than play no competition with Leeds. Brazil have a lot of players this summer, for this World Cup. A lot. There's Richarlison, there's our own Martinelli, there's Neymar, there's Vinicius, Firmino, Jesus, Rafinha, Antony from Ajax. There are so many players. So for Rafinha to get into that spot, into that starting lineup, you rather not just play the 15 games in the Premier League. You can play those 15 Premier League games and an addition 6 games in the Europa League to prove yourself and to prove the Brazilian coach, to show the Brazilian coach enough to actually be in the team. So he definitely knows about that. The ideal move would have been to a Champions League team, definitely, but the Barcelona is not there anymore, and Chelsea are focusing on other targets, and Tottenham are focusing on other targets. Great. And Arsenal is full of Brazilians as well. What can Rafinha ask for? What other thing can Rafinha ask for? So the deal could be done next week. They're doing a few other meetings in the next 48 hours. Some reports suggesting it's going to be Monday, a new meeting with the representatives of Rafinha, which is the likes of Deco, former Chelsea and Barcelona player. Funny enough, Deco is a former Barcelona and Chelsea player, but Rafinha, his player, could actually end up playing for Arsenal. Very, very funny. The next one is Lisandro Martinez, another player that we've been talking about, this time an Argentine player, though still from South America, so not complaining. South America always has that sauce when it comes to football. According to different reports, Fabrizio Romano reported yesterday that Arsenal have started new contacts with Lisandro Martinez's agent in the last 48 hours. So talks are ongoing. We gave them 30 million, they rejected it, and I'm now hearing they'll be okay with 40 million pounds, which is a lot of money for a defender, but he's very quality. He was Ajax player of the season last time out. I cannot wait for this one to be done as well. In terms of order, I expect Jesus to be announced. Okay, doesn't really matter when he's announced. As long as we know he's an Arsenal player, Arsenal could decide to milk it for another 1 week, which I don't mind. Jesus will probably be done by Tuesday of this week. Rafinha, if we go seriously into it, by the end of the week, it could be done. The Lisandro one could still be pushed to next month sometime. But as long as we get all of these players, that would be around 150 million pounds. That is almost the entire budget that we had this summer on a right winger, on a striker, and on a centre-back stroke left-back. That is good business. Rafinha has been Leeds' best player the last 2 seasons. Lisandro Martinez has been Ajax's best player from last season. He was voted the best player from last season. And Jesus scores goals. He scored more than 90 goals and assisted more than 40 times for Man City in just over 200 games. Quality, that is what you're buying. I'm never used to seeing Arsenal buying these kind of players, but this seems to be a different transfer window, and I'm definitely here for it. As we always say, I am here for it. I cannot wait to see what goes on. So, Edu, keep on cooking, keep on cooking the Brazilian food with the Argentine sauce on top. We cannot wait for these deals to be announced.